Sam Bob from Kadapa, well known to all of us, brother Sam Bob.
Yes, brother. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Dear brothers and sisters, join this Zoom. It's a great time. The memory of the righteous is blessed. The death of the saints is very precious in the sight of the Lord. Thank you, leaders of Shalom Assembly, for giving me the privilege of sharing certain things. Many have paid their tribute to dear brother MJ Babu and many others to follow on. I would like to say that he hails from United Andhra Pradesh. Before bifurcation, it was only one state. And Andhra Pradesh is known as preacher's paradise. That is the reason why so many preachers come here, move among these thousands of assemblies, and they minister the word of God. If at all we hear about brother MJ Babu, departed leader, it was because of another prince of preachers who was his mentor, called brother S. Anandam. S. Anandam simply means joyful. Brother Anandam was joyful. He was known as Andhra Spurgeon, Spurgeon of Andhra. So if at all we see any good qualities, we should remember that he hails from Vattapalle. That was where Mr. Anandam ministered, and that was from the same place he moved to many other places. Next to late Mr. Fox and Mr. Agrippa, the Lord used two of his servants called Brother S. Anandam and Brother S. Prabhudas. They were co-workers for 40 years. And Brother M.J. Babu, I know him since 1973. That was the first time when I went there to minister the word of God. From then on, he knows me. His parents know us. He ministered to us. So we have long association. By saying so, I don't want to take much time. He was prayerful, he was joyful, he was fruitful. He was very simple, he was humble, and he was very profitable. As a leader, as a preacher, as a speaker, he was a good orator and organizer. There are many good qualities we can learn from him. In Shalom Assembly, we ministered just once many years ago when Mr. Bhagavandas and Ruth were staying in Delhi. But it was in 2015, we were invited for a family conference by elders and members of Shalom Assembly. Now this meeting is also under the auspices of Shalom Assembly. In the departure of our dear brother MJ Babu, it's a great loss to dear sister Rebecca, dear Bobby, Mark Silas and his family, and dear daughter Sanuti and her family, and a loss to local assembly, Shalom Assembly, not only to Shalom Assembly, but all local assemblies of Delhi, because MJ Babu was not an exclusive man. He was having fellowship with all other assemblies. I want to say that MJ Babu was like a father and uncle to all missionaries who have gone from Andhra and Telangana. Just as we heard, there are at least 25 workers who have gone from Andhra and Telangana. Normally, though there are many hundreds of assemblies in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, believers of these two states are very homesick. So nobody would like to leave this state and go elsewhere. But it was MJ Babu who went there, and then from, say, 1983 or so. But he came to full-time ministry in 1986. From then on, he established good testimony. And we praise God for his family. We praise God for all his efforts. We praise God for the leadership he gave us. We praise God for all the skills that were in him. He was a well-dressed man. There are very few people from Andhra who can speak fluently English. He was one such. And there are very few people who can speak good Hindi. M.J. Babu was one such. So he was very systematic in his speech and in conducting meetings and conferences. Though two, three times we came to Delhi, each time they were taking care of us, his son, his family. There were times when they came to entertain us, though there was no time to take us to their home. We remember many places where we ministered the word of God. He was a very profitable speaker and teacher of God's word. We miss him. I want to say one thing. He had felt a genuine burden for workers who are not at all known to many other states and assemblies of states, those who have gone from Andhra and Telangana. So it was his burden to pray for them, to introduce them, to think of their support. We have been sharing many things of the needs of these 25 workers. Plus, there are some local workers. So there are at least 42 workers whom we know serving in north and northeastern states. We continue to pray for them. There is a small fellowship being extended to them through ABS, that is Assembly Believer Society, from Andhra State and Telangana State. That is not in against any other funding agency, but that is a very small help. Just to say that we are with the lost workers who are not known, whose needs are not known to many other believers. In the passing away of our dear brother M.J. Babu, I want to read just three verses, not preaching. 16:16 of John, 16:16, a little while and you will not see me, that is John Babu, and again a little while and you will see me, because I go to the Father. That M.J. Babu has gone to the Father and the separation is just for a little while. Verse 22, therefore you now have sorrow, Sister Rebecca, Silas, Sanuti families, and Shalom Assembly, but I will see you again, and your heart will rejoice, and your joy no one will take from you. Verse 33, these things I have spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer, I have overcome the world. It is as though M.J. Babu is saying to us, 17:4, I have glorified you on the earth. I have finished the work which you have given me to do. So he was clarifying the truth of the word of God. He was simplifying the mind of God to many people. And it was his point to glorify the Father. We praise him for the life and ministry of our dear brother, M.J. Babu, my co-worker. Thank you very much, brother.
Thank you.